What's up, everyone? Welcome back to a new video on the channel. Welcome to some Horizon 5. In today's video, I want to do something that I have been asked to do. It's mostly by new people joining the channel. By new people that have been watching some of the Wheelspin videos and they're joining the channel. Or is it the Wheelspin videos? I think it is. It's the Wheelspin videos and people sending me tunes, basically. And it's just new people saying that I should do this. And this is the main reason why I don't do this. Welcome to Open Racing, everybody. Welcome to Open Racing. Actual racing, not playground games, even though those are incredibly fun to do, and I'll definitely go back to doing those. But welcome back to Open Racing. I'm using the AMG 1 because I actually have to use it. I have to use it for an accolade. For people that don't know, I am trying to get pretty much every accolade completed in this game, and it's very difficult to do, but slowly does it, I guess. Very slowly, I will end up completing them. I don't even know which tune is on this car. I was actually not even paying attention. I was looking at the bottom right of my screen to see if this thing was a track mode and that. And, wow. Just wow. I don't like this tune. Whoever's tune I have on this thing, I don't like it. I'm not a fan. It just feels weird, and it feels like it just understeers a lot, even though it's on, like, slick tires. Brakes are good, though. So, yeah. I'm doing a bit of racing. Like I said, it's just something that I have to do. I realized the last time when I was playing with the Bronco in the Playground Games event, apparently I need to do it, or I need to use it for a race, so I still need to do that, but I also need to do this, and I have to play with the AMG one. These guys are so bad. One of them left already. Like, this is why I don't play open racing. This is exactly why I don't play open racing. People are just either really, really bad at it, or you have people that are like level 1,000, and I missed the checkpoint, because I hate this car, man. Who made this tune on this thing? I need to make my own. I really need to make my own. It doesn't matter, though. I have to just complete the event. I don't really have to win, even though I'm going to win it anyway. Regardless, I'm going to absolutely obliterate this guy in the next two races. This is my first time driving this car, by the way, with this tune on it. I don't even know what tune's on it, to be honest with you. I just downloaded some random tune that would put this thing to the top of S1. Or S2, sorry. But this thing is caca. Very bad. Let's try to see if I can catch up to this guy in this last lap, which I highly doubt it, but let's try it anyway. Why is the understeer so badly? Like, the stock one doesn't drive that bad. Just leave it alone. If you just left it completely stock, I think this would be a better car. God, it's so bad. The reason why I downloaded it too is because it's literally like 3 clicks, you know? Like, I don't have to go and make my own tune or anything like that. I can't believe I actually caught up to this guy. Finished it anyway. That was awful. We almost lapped a guy and one guy left. This is why I don't play online racing. It's just boring. It's either, like I said, you either have people that are really, really bad at it and they crash to everything, or you have people that are really, really sweaty at it and they use the most OP cars ever only, and so they can win everything. But you can see they're, like, I'm pretty sure because they're such a high rank, they've done this for a long time, so they're probably max rank already anyway, so they don't really need to do any of this sort of stuff, but they just do it anyway. I don't know. It's not really competitive at the point when you're just, like, being really, really sweaty against people that aren't trying, you know? I don't know. And then you have, like, just the sweats going head-to-head if you have multiple in the lobby, but it's just weird. Apparently, also, the last time when I was playing the Playground Games event, there was already sweaty people in it. Some guy in my Discord said, I can't believe that this is the first time Dubs plays Playground Games and there's already sweaty people in it. You know what I mean? Like, it's, there we go. One for all. I guess that was it. That was literally it. There, just complete the one race. Okay. Well, we have to complete this entire thing now. Anyway. So we'll see. What's the next one? That was the Emerald Circuit. I don't know what the next track is. I'm guessing we're going to have more people join as well, because it usually happens like that. You should have a few more people. The Panoramic Circuit. How many people are in this lobby now? There's only 3 of us. In the last one. Now, come on, just fill it up. There's only one more person joined. And he's sweaty. The XJR15. That is a sweaty car. Oh my god. Probably not for this track, but that is a sweaty, sweaty car. I need to be careful with this thing. I need to start steering, like, before I even see the corner. Because it starts to understeer so crazy. See? Like, the tiniest corner. Like, oh my god, this thing's ass, man. So bad. Like I said, I have to use this thing. Well, I had to for that one accolade. I can literally just leave now if I want to, but I'm not going to finish off this entire series. It, like, understeers and then just oversteers as well. I'm pretty sure it's on slick tires. I don't know what the diff setup is on this thing, but it is dog. What the f- It just glued itself to the wall. What? Was it trying to accelerate? I think that guy had the exact same thing. I saw him just stop at the wall. Or maybe he just came in a bit too fast, but, like, that was just... It's so weird. I started to accelerate. I was like steering away from the wall, but I just got stuck to it. Yeah, so this is why I don't play open racing. Or online racing, whatever you want to call it. Because this thing is just bad. It's just straight up bad. It's never consistent. I never get to drive on the same tracks. That's why I really liked the Golden Toga. It was just such a good track for... We're testing our cars and all that. Again, we're gonna have to find something new to test cars out on. But online racing is definitely not gonna be in the mix to to replace the Golden Toga, I'll tell you that. Alright, well, I'm finished. That was awful, man. Right, final event. Why am I starting up front if I'm leading? I don't know why. Oh, nobody else joined. Fantastic. I waited all that time. There was actually such a long waiting period there. Just so I can play with the same people. How did one of them crash already? I didn't even go around a corner yet, but he crashed. Both of those cars that they're driving should absolutely demolish this thing, by the way. Shouldn't even be close. This thing is not good. But, yet again. I'm ahead. I think one guy's about to get lapped. I'm calling it already. I think this guy that's just behind me is finally getting to the groove of driving his car because he's catching up to me. As he should be. And then he just ends up crashing into the wall, I think. These people just don't slow down for corners. I think that's what their deal is. They just don't slow down for corners and then I think they get penalized, right? When you start grinding off the wall. But as I said, they should be much faster than the way they're driving. Apollo's quite good. And then, obviously, there's the Lamborghini, which, you know the story with that one. I don't really have to explain myself. I don't know, maybe he's not going to get left. Maybe he's actually put his act together and he's actually racing again. A bit late, but... I might DNF though. I might get him to DNF. Let's have a look if I can do that. A bit mean, but... Just get good, lol. You know? I don't think I can get this guy behind me to DNF unless he crashes somehow. It's very polar opposites every time you get a lobby on Open Racing. I very, very, very rarely play it. It's mostly just for videos whenever I decide to make a video on it. But it's always like polar opposites. It's either really sweaty people or really bad people. There's no like in between. And you have people that constantly keep crashing as well. Like in the same lobbies with the really good people. Yeah, this guy's getting DNF'd. This guy's for sure getting DNF'd. He had a really good lap though. Like these guys are... like 1.5 seconds slower. And almost 2 seconds slower. Yeah, they're not that slow. He did DNF. Oh my god.
Oh my god. I'm the wiener.
Alright, let's move on. We'll do something else. And, of course, I had to do this just to get the accolade, but let's do something else. I'm gonna try and do the thing with the Bronco. I wanna try and see if I can do a little bit of off-road racing. Or rally racing now. Oh, I'm in a race already. Brilliant. It just means I don't have to wait around, you know? Okay. Okay. Horizon Wilds races in the Bronco. How many people am I racing against? Please don't be, like, one more. Oh my god! Come on, man! Why are the lobbies so dead? Am I not allowed to search? Did they make this like so badly? I don't know what to say, man. So if I search like a regular game, and I have to accidentally get put into the game mode that I want to play on, only then will I have people join? Oh god, this is so bad on the road. God, so is that guy. It's just weird, like, why wouldn't you not, like, put the matchmaking together? And not just use this as a filter? I think it's completely different, like... It's a completely different playlist. So here's what I'm talking about, right? If I go into custom racing, right, and I pick exactly the class of car that I want to race with. Or sorry, not the class of car, but yeah, it is the class of car, right? If I don't pick, like, you know, A-class cars and off-road racing, why isn't that linked up? I don't think it is. Why isn't it linked up to the other one where you just click on the random search and it searches a random racing event and it just put you in one of these anyway? I don't understand. I don't think they're linked because usually you'll have more people in the other ones for the people that just randomly search. And I just don't understand why. It's so badly optimized. It's so weird. He left. My guy straight up left. I was looking at the minimap when I like slowed down and crashed there. And there's just nobody on a minimap. This is the worst game mode, I think, on this. It's so odd, man. I don't understand why the playlists aren't linked together. And I'll show you, because straight after this, I don't really have to do all three races. I'm just going to do this one here. And then I'll go into, like, the regular thing, right? And I'll search a regular one, I'll guarantee you it's going to be a full lobby. Even though people will leave after the first race, you'll have more people join it. All the time. But it just doesn't make sense to me why they're not linked. Like, the other one should literally just be a filter. That's it. That should just be a filter. If there isn't a lobby that's set up for that, then make them wait like a minute. Until there is one set up for it. I'll show you exactly what I'm talking about as well, straight after this, when I'm going to search for another game. But I had to do this again for an accolade. If you guys remember the last time I ended up playing with this thing. It was in Playground Games, and it was supposed to be an open racing, but I had to do it. Wow, I won! What a surprise, am I right, guys? Playing on my own! If it's just one extra player, I'm leaving. There's no point. Yeah, I'm not playing this. Like, 1v1, and the guy's just gonna end up leaving. What a dumb lobby. Seriously, what a stupid, stupid lobby. Like, why isn't this... I don't understand why this just wouldn't be, like I said, connected to the other playlist. It just makes absolutely no sense. Right, so here, let me show you real quick exactly what I'm talking about. So, if you go into online, and you go to Horizon Open, If I click on custom racing, right, you choose your class and your race type, right? Perfectly fine. But it should be the same thing as this. This just has a playlist that has all of them together, grouped up together. But if I click on this, I guarantee you that I'll find a game full of people, and it'll stay full of people. Even if the people from that one lobby end up leaving, you'll have others that join in. And it'll be constantly like that. But if I go into the custom one, right, and I look for, let's say, I'll see what pops up exactly now, right? Let me see. Exactly what pops up now. If I look up A-class, and I look up cross-country, I should have this playlist pop up right here, exactly what I've found right now with this car. I should have it pop up here. But it doesn't. And it makes no sense why it doesn't, right? Because it'll just create a whole new lobby, or it'll find the lobby that has just been created that's the same as this. But I won't join into this one. Why not? Why isn't that custom one just a filter for the rest of the playlist? That makes absolutely no sense. You're creating a whole dead lobby, and it's just people that don't search for specific... You'll have a lot less people search for specific races than they do searching for this one, which is very broad. Look at the amount of people in this lobby. I'm all the way at the back. It's full. It is full of people. Look at it. See what I mean? Like, it just makes absolutely no sense why that event or that custom playlist thing is not linked up to this. And it's not just this event here, the cross-country A-class. It's all of them. All people play this. This is a massive issue. It makes no sense at all for them to, like, split those two together like that. It just makes zero sense. Because if you want to get into a lobby that actually has people in it, you can't even do the custom one. Like, you can't search for a custom one. You legitimately have to search for this. And if you don't find one that you can use... Let's say you build something for, you know, Rally Racing B-Class. Why is this Virgin crashing into me? Yeah, each... I'd rather fall to the back. Constantly get pushed around by that guy. This guy doesn't deserve to be in fourth place. He drove like an absolute... Which just literally started pushing everybody out of the way, and he managed to get to this place. Deserve that. I don't care if I come in first, or if I come in fifth, that guy should be last place. He came in seventh? How did he even come in seventh place? He crashed into a tree. Somehow he was just fine anyway. Maybe the thing was broken. I don't know. So yeah, basically there's a fundamental, like that was the last event. There's a fundamentally broken system with open racing. So that's what I'm saying, like if I let's say, like, it's like I said, if I were to play in like B-class rally racing, right? B-class rally racing, I have to go into this, and I have to keep spamming this until I find B-class rally racing. If I want to play against other people. If I don't find the lobby that's B-class rally racing, well, tough luck. Right, that's pretty much it. That is, imagine if I found one right now, straight up. Oh no, it's S1900, I don't want to play that, let's back out. You know, if I go and I search specifically for B-class rally racing here, which I can, so there's dirt racing, and there's B-class. And if I click confirm, it'll find me the exact game that I want, right? But just like, nobody in it. Nobody will end up being in it. Because people only search the one that gets given to them on the front page of this, which is just completely random. But these two, this one and this one, aren't connected. So this one here isn't a filter to find a lobby that can also be here in this playlist. That's what makes this such a stupid thing in open racing. And it makes absolutely no sense. So for the people that are asking, why don't I play open racing? It's because it's stupid. It's very stupid. If I want to play against other people, it's almost impossible to find people to play against. If I try to do something very, very specific. But anyway, I wanted to do that because I wanted to get the two accolades done for the online Horizon Open events, which is this one here, and then this one over here. Alright, well, that was it for today's video. thank you for watching, everybody. I will see you in the next one. I still have a bunch of these to do. Not too many, though. I think if I play a few more Playground Games events, I think we should be perfectly fine with doing these. Infecting players and healing players and all that sort of stuff again. It just pretty much just play the game. That's literally it. I'm going to use my own phrase for me. I just have to play the game. That's it. I need to play Flag Rush, though. The last time when we played it, I got booted out of it, if you guys remember. So I need to play Flag Rush as well and do a bunch of these. Right. Yeah. That is pretty much it. Reach top speed of 250 miles an hour. I haven't done that one. Really weird. Remain uninfected for 180 seconds at a single round. How do I remain uninfected for a single round of... What? Oh. Oh, okay. Okay, never mind. Never mind. I was wondering. I was like, I thought I did this. But I didn't end up doing this. Okay, fair enough. That's pretty much it. Thank you for watching, everybody. And I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye, everyone.